It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention?
What time is it?
I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story.
Now Myers to win the league, yes!
And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen.
Dance and boom!
With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Cannonball!
Happy season.
Well, hello and Merry Christmas and welcome
Merry
to
Christmas.
The Below the Rim Christmas show.
it's
quiz time. I don't know if anyone's got any drinks in, but mine's a pina colada. Game on. Oh, we got some beers down there as well, and an iron brew.
Oh, we should swap, Paul.
Well, they've been very loud. It's not often during a quiz that the contestants are gobbing off before we even start. Let me introduce you to today's quiz. What do you call them? What are you called? LMs.
Legends.
Today's competitors. It's a head-to-head affair. It's what some might term as the perfect three-way. Merry Christmas.
A bunch of good-looking guys.
A bunch of good-looking fellas. Let's start with that voice. No, let's not start. Let's go traditional. My main man, Ads, is in the quiz. How are you, sir? And what's your mascot?
Well, I'm drinking green tea. And the only reason I'm drinking green tea is because I've run out of milk, and green tea you can get away with without milk. My mascot, I've got three mascots.
Oh, hello.
The first one is going to rub Nicholson's nose in it a bit because it came through the post today, but my beautiful Michael Jordan number 45 Funko Pop arrived today. So I'm happy with that.
Paul's hoping his missus has gotten that for Christmas.
I hope so.
Mrs. Nicholson. The other thing I've got as a mascot, and I'm going to try and find a way for him to be on the screen at all times, is this little fella here. Now, that's my spare, because I like it so much, I had to get a spare, Dominique Wilkins Funko Pop.
Oh, nice.
Now, this one, if you look at him, he's wearing a headband.
He is.
He's wearing a Big Dog Bowling wristband.
Nice, good work.
Which makes for a perfect Funko Pop headband. So we've got that. Now,
that's tough.
My final mascot, Pabz, is this.
Pizza cutter.
It's my favourite pizza cutter. Because what I've also got, my other mascot, is I've got two Chicago Town pizzas. And I'm going to use my lucky cutter to cut the pieces and eat pizza while we do this.
Good man.
So, cheers.
Good stuff. Well done. Let's introduce the next competitor, the media guru, all the way from Plymouth, Mr. Paul Nicholson. How are you? And what's your mascot?
Oh, good. I had pizza today as well, actually. anyway, we digress. So, I got one mascot. Well, I've got a few other items to show. Obviously, a can of Iron Brew, just to pay homage to Grant below us.
Not as good as Iron Brew from Scotland, I've heard.
That's
like Guinness. It's like Guinness from Ireland. It's not as good.
I've also got my thinking hat with me today.
Hello.
I only put this on when I'm thinking. Okay. Got this.
Oh my god. That's phenomenal. For those of you listening to the podcast and not watching the video, this it is a Fantasia Mickey Mouse hat, complete with ears.
He looks like a very camp wizard.
So I got my thinking hat on, and I will now introduce you to my mascot. And there's a story behind why he's my mascot.
Well, we haven't even got to the mascot yet. Go on, yeah.
I'd like to share
that in the office.
Excuse me, Grant. Don't interrupt me.
Yeah, we're not introduced you yet.
There's a story behind my mascot, which I'd like to share with you, which is a relatable story. Okay. So this.
It's Ratatouille.
This is
Are you ready to take the cooking challenge?
Wow.
So this is Remy.
I'm genuinely impressed by that.
We found him in a charity shop.
What?
Good find. actually worth quite a lot on eBay. Generally is, true story.
That's phenomenal.
So, the story though, why this is relatable. Mm. Yeah, Remy is a rat, obviously chasing his dreams to be a master chef. Go through trials and tribulations in the process, makes a lot of mess, does a lot of wrong things, does a lot of good things, but eventually comes out on top winning. Ladies and gentlemen, meet Remy.
Brilliant. That's your story?
That's it, mate.
Slight flaw, because actually technically he doesn't do anything wrong. He's a master straight away. But
you need to rewatch the film.
I don't. I really don't. Go up, my man.
It's one of the greats.
The third contestant for tonight's show, for tonight's quiz, all the way from sunny Scotland, Mr. Grant Young. How are you? What's your mascot?
It was. We had the highs of -10 last week. I had no heating, no water. The violins were out. I had my Christmas jumper on most days to try and cheer me up. My red nose, and he even came with a wee pocket to put my beer in.
It was a typical August in Scotland.
It's got a beer pouch.
So that wasn't part of my mascot, but what's this show become quite a big fan of in recent weeks? Is Bluey.
Oh, of course.
Viewers love it. And decided to join me as my mascot, and hopefully you'll be able to see him throughout. Bluey wasn't available, but I've got Bingo.
Oh, amazing. And I'm a big fan.
What Bingo, there's an episode of Bluey where they're having a barbecue and Bingo is stressing over the salad.
Yeah.
And what is Bandit doing? Drinking beer.
You know what? Barbie.
As I'm stressing and Bingo's stressing over the quiz questions and probably getting everything wrong, at least I've got my beer.
Oh, good one. Good one. It's got a bit of a cult following, that, Bluey, on our Discord channel, which is fantastic. Even to the point where everyone updates each other if a Bluey toy becomes available in Aldi, for example. It's absolutely brilliant. Right, fellas, the first up, we have the guesstimation round. A series of questions which will need you to estimate how many points, assists, perhaps rebounds. We'll get to that, obviously. A team or a player has amassed over a certain period of time. And obviously the closest one will win. So there's no need to shout or press any buzzers or shout out or anything like that. What we'll do is we'll go, we've got three rounds. We'll alternately go with three questions in each bit of it. We'll go with a different one of you first, second and third, if you see what I mean. Which I may forget, and you'll have to gently remind me. But let's start the first one. So Peter Scantlebury is the BBL's highest scorer of all time. But Nigel Lloyd is second, and it's Nigel Lloyd's figure that we actually want from you. So how many points in his BBL career did Nigel Lloyd score? Let's start with Grant.
Damn it. I was hoping I'd be last to try and go in between. I'm going to say 9,800.
Ads, my man?
Nigel Lloyd. I wonder if he broke 10K. 10,807, I believe it was.
But see, this is just league, by the way. Does that change anybody's estimation?
I feel like it should.
Hey, once they're in, they're in. The answers are in.
Go on then, Nicholson.
9,700.
Well, I can tell you, Peter Scantlebury was the highest scorer, obviously. We said that already, with near on 8,000 points. In second place, obviously, is Nigel Lloyd, and that's the figure we wanted, 7,838, which means, Mr. Nicholson, you have the first point of the quiz. Congratulations. Let's move on to...
I honestly thought Scantz was over 10,000, so...
The next question. No, sorry about that. You could end up with a blankety-blank checkbook at pen at the end of this one. Oh, whatever. Marcus Gaither had 35.3 points per game. That is the highest ever achieved by a BBL player in one single season. But how many points did he actually amass for that season? Ads, my man.
What year was it?
Well,
makes any difference whatsoever. I'm just delaying while I think.
Second or third year, I think it was. 89, right, so. Perhaps. Early on.
What was his average?
35.3.
Okay.
Nicholson's counting on his fingers, for those of you listening on the podcast.
2,400.
Let's go Nicholson next.
You said for a season, right?
One season, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Just checking. Oof. 700.
He's gone 700. Grant, my man.
I'm going 1,000.
He's going 1,000. The actual figure for the whole season was 846 points.
What's with Nicholson?
He's happy.
Being the best fluky guesser of all time.
I think he should be banned from wearing a hat.
I made a career out of this.
I'm getting a bit psyched out by
giving him luck.
His rat staring literally right
so
at us.
Yeah, that's quite eerie, isn't it, when he puts it close up to the screen? I don't mean the rat either. Anyway, in your endo, the most points ever scored in a BBL single season was 1,060 points. Now, bearing in mind the last set of estimations, but how many points per game was that? Oh, how funny. Nicholson, you're going first this time.
Damn it. So there must be more teams in the league.
Point five is the get. Who hasn't been second yet? That'd be Grant. Then is it Grant? Is it you? It must be you.
I'm going 31.6.
You're going 31.6. Ads, my man.
32.5.
God, I might have to get my calculator out to work out who's got this one. Right.
Hold up.
Yeah.
Can you go with the same guess as me?
Oh, yeah, you can't. Yeah, we've got 32.5 already. What sort of a quiz master is this?
What I meant was 32.8.
We'll change yours then to 32.8. And I can tell you, just give me 2 seconds. I realise I've made a very slight error. The points per game for that season was 33.1. So the nearest is Ads. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So that's a running total of the scores if you want it. 2 points to Nicholson. 1 point to Ads, and no points to Grant. We move on to the assists category, still guesstimations. The most total assists for a season has been achieved by Fabulous Filornoy. How many assists was it? Grant, my man.
Say that question again, sorry.
The most assists, not in a season, my apologies. Career total assists, I should say. Oh, a season. I don't think he's ever had that, to be fair. He played for so long there.
That's why I got confused by the question.
The most total assists, career assists, is Fabulous for Lorne. How many is it? Go on, Grant. Career assists. Oh, he's asking Bingo. Bingo's Australian. Might give an Aussie rules answer.
Bandit's a huge cricket fan, so it'd probably be how many sixes. He probably knows that one. I'm going to go for 2,800.
2,800 assist as the guest there. Ads, you're next.
It's a difficult one, isn't it?
Yeah.
$1,950.
Good stuff. Nicholson?
It is a really difficult one because I'm thinking of milestones of guys that have been in the league and in our program and where they are, but they were point guards.
Mm, very obviously true.
Fab was not a point guard, but he was in the league a very long time. How long was he in the league? Jeez.
Whatever.
20 plus years.
Longer than there was a league, actually.
There you go.
I'm going to actually go around 3,000.
He's gone for 3,000. I can tell you the actual answer is 2,177.
Did I get that?
No,
so
I get that.
1950, I believe, is nearer than 2,800.
Oh, I said 2,800. Damn it.
Yeah. That picks up another point.
I'm like, Ramon, almost bingo. Almost.
Ramon Fletcher has the highest assists per game, 10.6 for a season. This is, but how many assists did he get that season in total? Let's go with Ads first this time. 10.6 assists. How many assists would that be? Mathematically, you could all be quite close. Because you know roughly how many games he possibly played. I'm not sure if he missed any out.
Is this in a single season?
Single season.
800.
Nicholson? You're muted, Mr. Nicholson, sir.
God damn it. 311.
311. And Grant?
Hey, so 10.6.
10.6 a game.
270.
That is possibly the guess of the night as Ramon Fletcher managed 266 assists that season.
No, hey.
Bravo.
Let's go, bingo.
Which gives that point.
Apologies for my 800 prediction. That was gross, stupid.
It was very, very generous.
He played 90 games that season or something.
Yeah, sorry.
So, 266 is a lot of assists, you'll agree. However, it's not the most for a single season. That record belongs not to Alton Bird, but to Russ Saunders. How many is it? Let's go. Who's chart is Nicholson first this time, isn't it? Go on, Mr. Nicholson.
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
So, 266 is a lot of assists in one season, but it's not the most. The most is Russ Saunders. How many did he achieve?
I'm going to go back to my original. I'm going to go 311.
Grant?
$295.
He's added a five. Ads, my man.
$312.
Well, I can tell you that one of you has had the very best estimation that we've had in this round thus far. For the most assists, and I'm just going to squint and check because I've got it quite small so I can put it on the screen. The most assists in a single season is 296. Congratulations, Grant.
Nah.
One single assist off.
What a round I'm having.
Let's go, bingo.
So the third part of the estimations round and final part of the estimations round, you'll be glad to know, is the team stats round. This is going to be quite entertaining, judging on some of your estimations going. 2011-12, the Eagles swept. But what was their total points for the team? Grant, you're first. Total team points for the season 2011 and 2012.
Well, that year, I don't know why I'm going to try and give you a synopsis, however that is. I'm going to try and give you a rundown because I say there was 2,504. That laugh means I'm miles away.
No, it's really funny. The specific, mind you, why not be specific? You might be bang on. Who knows? Ads, my man, you're next.
I don't understand the question. Is it
So one, right, there's 2011-12 season, the Eagles swept their total points, as in
right. Points so are we scored. Talking points in the, right? Because I was thinking points in the league.
No, no, no. All players combined points scored.
Right. Okay.
I had to do my maths there to double check I'd added enough zeros in.
Oh, this could be.
Was this league only? Off.
Yeah, this league. This is all championship only.
Okay.
How many points in a season? Rings a bell.
Rings a bell. Nicholson?
I want to go to Ads School of Counting.
Nicholson's counting. Nicholson's got his socks off right now. He's counting toes, fingers.
I'm going to go with 3,900.
Well, he's having a hell of a round. The total amassed in points for the Eagles in that season was 2,983. Congratulations. Another point. He was on zero earlier, and now he's running away with things.
Those Bengals wee pep talk. Do you not see us talking? That's all that was.
Guess the point. 2016-17 season, the Riders completed the treble. The Riders also led the league in team assists. How many did they amass? Ads, my man. So total team assists for the season 2016-2017.
I don't even know what would be a respectable figure to guess at for how many assists in a season.
Well, we know that the most ever is by one player is 266, but that obviously is a single player stat, and that's, I imagine, right. The rest of the players on that team would probably average one or two assists.
712.
So Ads goes 712. Is it Nicholson? Yeah, Nicholson next.
Five
oh two for Nicholson. Grant?
540.
41. I can tell you that the actual answer, the league leading assists team total for the Riders in that season was 702. Well done, Adam. Ads, my man. Takes that one.
Yeah, back in it.
Last one in the team category. 2018-2019, Lions did the double, which would have been league and, was it league and cup or league and trophy? Because they had the tremendous trophy game against the Royals. 2018-19. They did the double. They led the team category for rebounds. So how many rebounds did the Lions total for that season? Nicholson, my man.
Right, okay. I'm going to go for 905.
I legit was going to say 905.
Nicholson goes 905. Well, it's your guess next, Grant.
I'm going to go 909.
909. Ads, my man. Total assists for the Lions in the 18-19. Oh, sorry. Yeah, rebounds. Total rebounds. What sort of a quiz master am I? Total rebounds, Ads, my man.
1,012.
I can tell you the answer for that season with the Lions leading the league in rebounds as a team was 1,406.
Well done, Ads.
So Ads gets God, that one.
I'm having a nightmare.
So, after the first round, the scores are Paul Nicholson is on 2 points. Grant Young is on 3 points, but in the lead is Adam Masters with 4 points. Woo-hoo!
Excellent.
My thinking hat has run out of battery, I think. Really,
this is the University Challenge section of the show. Cue the music. So what we do now is it is a finger on buzzers. You need to shout out your name. First one to shout out your name gets to answer the question. There's some tough questions here. What that will lead to is five questions for you and you alone. In your start for five. Got it?
Rather than shouting the names out, can I use another one of my mascots?
What you got?
Realised my stylophone is right next to me.
We got a stylophone.
I could use Remy.
You got to use a mascot.
How reliable is Remy?
I'm not going to get any chances. This makes no noise.
Whack the mic with it.
I don't think Remy's going to be quick enough.
Pat the mic with it. Right, I'll settle for names. Don't worry, I'll settle for names. Okay, fingers on buzzers. Are you ready? First question. Who were the first British team to play in a European competition?
Kingston.
Is that Adam? Adam Masters, what's your answer?
You didn't say
Kingston.
It is not Kingston. Nicholson and Grant, you can buzz in at any time. It was mentioned on Twitter recently. Go on in, Grant.
Who did they become? Glasgow Rangers.
It's not Glasgow Rangers. So Nicholson, you've got the free deal. It was recently mentioned a team was going to possibly be entering the BBL, and it had roots.
Am I
going
right
back.
In saying? I think wasn't it Dublin Stars?
Oh, you're so close.
Or Dublin?
Ooh.
No, it was the Belfast Celtics.
Belfast.
Who actually had to play Real Madrid, who were the European best team in Europe, and thousands of people packed into the tiny little centre in Belfast back in like 1930, something like that. Next question then, fingers on buzzers. I'm not going to say anything. Who played for both the Worthing Bears and Manchester Giants and became known as the Dunk King? I was sure Ads was going to get this because we talked about this not that long ago.
Worthing Bears.
Just take a sip of my drink here.
Go on, Ads.
Colin Irish?
Slam Dunk King. Any guesses for anyone else?
Pass from me and Remy.
No, we'll move on. The answer was Leo Rogers.
Yorick Williams.
Leo Rogers.
Oh!
That was Worthing Bears, not Brian.
Leo.
You noticed every time Ad strikes that thing, his camera stalls.
Right, next question. Fingers on buzzers. Prior to the Riders playing in Europe, who was the last BBL team to compete in a European competition?
Grant.
Go on, Grant.
Hey, no swearing. Was it Guildford Heat?
It's yes, then. So you get your start for five. Well done.
That's good.
You're not getting
a good thing.
So, your starter for five, the category is MVPs.
Woo!
Who was the oldest player to win a finals MVP?
Who won it that year?
No, this is his own questions. He's got the five questions.
Who won the oldest?
Who was the oldest
I'm
person?
I'm going to say, when did they win something? I want to say Darius Defoe.
I'm afraid not. It's Alan Cunningham.
That's what I would have said.
Who
it's
was
one of those answers with Pabz, if you actually say Alan Cunningham to every answer, you get it at least twice.
Yeah, or Worthing Bears.
Who? Well, obviously that's wrong, though. Who was the first ever league MVP?
Alan Cunningham.
Is that your guess? Is that genuinely your guess? I should have done that for a round, just had Alan Cunningham as the answer for every single one and one Alton Bird.
I don't know.
Okay, it was Daryl Thomas who played for Indiana in college and made the assist for the championship winning game. I think which two players have amassed the most MVPs across all competitions? There's two players.
I'm going to say Drew Sullivan's one of them.
That's one. You can have a point for that.
Oh, yes. Come on. Hey, thanks, Paul. Appreciate it.
You get
that.
Another point if you get the other one.
How recent?
I'm not telling you. Come on.
Alan Cunningham.
No. No, I thought you would have got that from having got Drew Sullivan. It's the Leisure Centre era guys, Drew Sullivan and Charles Smith.
I was going to say Charles Smith. Damn it.
Last two questions for your starter. How many players have achieved three MVPs in just one season?
How many guys? So I want to say 17.
Or I misunderstood just, the question. Yeah, I think you might have misunderstood the question. How many players have achieved in one single season? There's four MVPs up for grabs, trophy, cup, playoff, and league. How many have managed to get the most? Like Gino got a treble last year, so it's at least one.
Sorry, misunderstood the question. I'm going to say five.
You're not far off. It's three. Gino, Charles Smith, and Trey Moore. And last question for you. Which player has the most MVPs without a league MVP? Well, I wish I'd written down the number of how many finals MVPs he's actually got. But
are we talking Leisure Centre either?
No, no. No, we're talking genuine shout for one of the best players ever to play the game and not to get a league MVP.
Oh. Paul, I wish you had this round.
Buzz.
Paul James.
No. Nicholson?
I know he's one of the boys, one of the most.
You want to guess Nicholson?
I'm going to guess purely on the way you talked about it. Fletch.
Fletch has got two league MVPs.
Oh, okay. I didn't even listen to the question properly.
It's John McCourt.
I must have missed out the
one of the best players to play in this league and not to get a league MVP. So we're back to the starters. I've only got a few starter questions left, so you better get these right. Between 1988 and 1992, who dominated the BBL Ed Percival Coach of the Year Award?
What year, sorry?
The first, 1988 to 1992.
Kevin Cadle.
Correct. Adds, my man. And your category for five is ironically coaches, more specifically coach of the year. Well, Ad, before you do your start, you've changed your mascot. You've got the five questions coming up, which is going to be about coach of the year. What's your mascot? Oh, he's got an actual rat. An actual rat.
I was getting a bit freaked out by Nicholson's rat staring at me. So I thought I'd go one better. Let me just move the camera down a little bit. So,
my God.
It's not going to make a break for a pipe or something, is it?
No.
Don't let him see the Paul's rat. There could be some humping on the screen.
Oh, good Lord. Oh, my God, there's another one. He's got more than one.
I love that. I used to have pet rats as well. This is amazing.
He looks just like Remy as well, this one. There he is.
This has turned into pet corner. Right. He's like, what the hell? That rat can cook.
Give me some cheese.
Yeah. Right, Ads, you ready?
I am. Let me just get my...
Okay. First question. Which two-time coach of the year is the only coach to win the award whilst coaching the Thames Valley Tigers?
Mickey Bett.
It certainly is. That's a point for Ads. Which coach has amassed the most Coach of the Year awards since 1987 and the start of the league?
Kevin Cadle.
It's not Kevin Cadle, it's Rob Paternostro.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Which two coaches, now NBA coaches, followed each other in winning the award twice?
Nick Nurse and Chris Finch.
It is indeed. In which season did Billy Mims win his only Coach of the Year award whilst coaching the London Leopards?
Oh, guys, the year they smashed everyone. 98?
It is 98. Well done, sir.
Since getting these rats out, one of them's worryingly gone missing. But anyway, carry on.
Who are the last five winners of the Coach of the Year?
Rob Paternostro. Rob Paternostro. Rob Paternostro. last five, right. Rob, Rob, Vince, Fab.
So we've got Rob twice, Vince. There's no Fab on there, I'm afraid.
No Fab on there.
Oh, whoa!
Oh, hello. We've got competitiveness going
right
on
there,
here.
Grant.
So let's go back in order. 21-22 was
Rob.
Yes. 2020-21 was
Rob.
Correct. There was no one, obviously, for the COVID season. So 2018-2019 was
Vince.
It was 2017-2018.
Vince.
No, it was Rob. But I'll give you 2016-2017.
Vince.
It was Rob as well. Rob has won many of the last ones. So
that's why it's sort of a semi-trick question. It's like, well, yeah, Rob every year since, you know what I mean?
Well, to be fair, you got 2 points in that round from that question. You got two right, first two. Last couple of questions then, everybody in, fingers on buzzers. Which team won the first ever league title but failed to win the playoff final?
Repeat the question.
Go on, Paul.
This is just a completely random guess. I'm going Birmingham Bullets.
It's not the Birmingham Bullets. As the question was, the first team to win the league but didn't win the playoffs. That's just a little clue, but not obviously that hasn't worked. First team to win the BBL league.
Grant Towers.
Go on, Grant. What did you say? Towers.
London Towers.
It's not the Towers.
Thames Valley Tigers.
It's not the Thames Valley Tigers. It's Portsmouth FC.
I'll be damned.
There you go. We've got a couple. We've got one question left, so you've got to get this one, fellas. Kingston Kings won everything except the BBL Cup in 3 seasons, but who stole the cup from them? Go on, Ads.
Sunderland.
It was Sunderland. Well done, Ads. That gives you another 5 questions. God, you've got a chance to build up quite a lead.
Performance-enhancing rats.
Your question is related to the BBL playoffs. And the first question. Okay. First question. Who has won the most playoff finals in his career?
What, player or coach?
Player.
Who's won the most BBL playoffs in his career? Is it Russ Saunders?
It's not Russ Saunders. If you'd have gone for the bog standard answer, it is Alan Cunningham.
I was kidding, but I thought, no, surely he won't do it. And that's why the only reason I didn't say Cunningham was because I was like, surely he won't do this.
Who was the first ever playoff finals MVP? I didn't know this, so good luck.
Right, so we know it's not Alan Cunningham then.
Well, they lost. First. He was Portsmouth, yeah.
We get a year or...
1987-88, the first BBL season. The first playoff finals MVP. No, it wasn't Alton Bird. Graham Hill. Next question. Name any venues that have been used for the playoff finals. There's 3 points up for grabs.
Wembley.
Wembley is one.
The O2.
Yeah, the O2. Sorry, there's 4 up for grabs. Idiot. Yeah.
Wembley, the O2.
Wembley, the O2.
The NEC.
The NEC is one, yeah.
For some reason, I've got it in my head that Sheffield once did it.
No.
No?
You get 3 points. Go on then, Grant.
It's going to be Glasgow, isn't it?
Did Worcester not host the finals during the COVID season?
Clever.
Well. They hosted the quarterfinals.
Yeah.
Leicester for the finals.
Yeah.
Do we get points for that?
Well, no, you don't. But in that case, there's 5 up for grabs. Because
I've got one. The Royal Albert Hall.
No, that was the cup.
Oh, shit.
Have I just answered a question for later on? I hope not.
Remember that one, lads?
No, it was the Birmingham NIA as well. Well, there you go. You got 3 for that one. 2 more questions. Name 2 teams that have recorded a 3-peat in playoffs.
Two teams that have recorded a three-peat.
There's three... why have I put two? There's three teams that have done it. No, hang on. One, two, three, four. There's four teams that have done it. I don't know why I've put two. Maybe I was restricting points at that stage, but no, let's not. Let's name the teams that have done a three-peat in the playoffs. There's 4 points up for grabs.
Leicester.
Leicester is one. They did that quite recently as well, which nobody really made a fuss about, and I thought they should have done.
Kingston.
Kingston is another one, yep. There's two more up for grabs.
Newcastle.
Newcastle Eagles. There's one more.
Worthing.
It is Worthing. Congratulations. All 4 points. Well done, sir.
Rat power.
Last question.
Did you find the other one?
Did you find the other one?
No. He's around somewhere. I can hear him, but I can't see him.
Last question for five, then. Who are the last three players to win the playoff finals MVP?
Gino Crandall.
Gino is one.
Gino Crandall.
Gino Crandall did not win it again. No, he's only won it once. He's only won the finals once.
You're asking for the last three?
Last three playoff final MVPs. Gino won it last time.
Didn't Liggins win it?
No, they didn't. They've not won the playoffs.
Oh, shit. Playoffs.
How many players have you guessed? Three. Is that three players you've guessed?
Two.
You got one more guess.
Fletch?
No, not Fletch. Guys, do you want to help him out? Do you know?
It was a Newcastle player.
It was?
COVID season.
Yeah. Justin Gordon. Okay. Yeah. It was...
partner in crime with Fletch.
Cortez Edwards.
Cortez Edwards. Yeah.
And then we
have
to skip one because of COVID season, which gives us the Riders completing their three-peat. And anybody know? Anybody remember the winner of the MVP game?
It wasn't Pierre Hampton, was it?
No.
No.
Big man, he cropped up, he did something recently, wherever he's at now. Tim Williams, the big fella.
Ah, yes.
Then couldn't have told you that one.
Fingers on buzzers. Which team has given us the most MVPs and how many have there been?
Grant.
Go on, Grant.
I'm going to go Newcastle with 5.
It is Newcastle. I'll give you the point for Newcastle.
Can I give another number?
I was going to say, we should keep that one going.
Maybe I've messed up on that one.
No, I get the point.
Anyway, it was 7. Grant gets the 5 questions. sorry, Nicholson.
Just give me a lifeline somewhere, please.
Your final category is the BBL Cup and Trophy.
London Albert Hall.
Which player has won the most BBL Cups?
Charles Smith.
Oh. Cunningham. You should have thought about that because it was obviously last year. It was all big news. Darius Defoe.
Oh, balls.
Which player has won the most BBL trophies?
Darius Defoe.
Drew Sullivan.
Hiya.
Name a player that has achieved finals MVP in the cup and trophy, not in the same season.
Ramon?
There's three players up for grab. Ramon's not one of them.
Same season.
No, it's not. It's not the same season. But they're the only three that have done it in the cup and the trophy.
Oh, right. Not the same. Okay.
A couple of recent names.
Up and trophy. Ish. Zaire Taylor?
No.
And one more guess. Cup and trophy. Jamal Williams?
No. John McCord, Charles Smith and Drew Sullivan.
Why have I not said Charles Smith for every answer here? I would have got
Drew Sullivan, you'd have done all right as well. Name any team that have completed the cup and trophy double in a single season. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 teams to guess. spanning across the generations as well.
So Cheshire Jets.
The Jets is one, yeah.
Newcastle Eagles.
Eagles is two.
Leicester Riders.
Nope.
Oh, same season. Brighton Bears.
No, Bears never did that. We never won the trophy. Got one more guess. And I mean, I'm amazed that when I bang on about this team, how many of you don't listen? It's honestly, it's inspiring.
I feel like I know she get this, but I don't really listen to Pabz often, do I? So won both same season. I don't know. Who did Alan Cunningham play for?
He did play for him. I'm gonna have to hurry you. No,
don't know.
Teams you missed out: Kingston Kings, who won everything.
Of course.
We said it before, won everything for three seasons, except for the
forget that you're obsessed. Go to sleep in your Kingston Kings pajamas.
And the Bracknell Tigers were the other team. Which there you go. Final question: who won the last three cup and the last three trophy finals? So there's 6 points up for grabs on this one.
And this is just for me.
Just for you.
So we've got.
You got three guesses on the cup. You got three guesses on the trophy.
Cheshire Phoenix.
For which?
Oh, I've seen random six.
No. Is that for the cup or trophy?
They won the trophy.
That's okay. That's one trophy guess, correct?
Who won it that season? They beat London. Newcastle Eagles. They beat Solent.
Eagles are trophy as well. Yep.
Yeah. Sorry, trophy. Who won it the season before? COVID season. No, that was the COVID season. Was 1920. Was Newcastle. Who won it 2021? Did London win it 2021?
They certainly did. That's three for three on the trophy. You've still got three guesses on the cup.
Okay, so. Cup last season. Leicester Riders.
Correct.
London Lions.
Incorrect. One more guess.
What was that final? Cheshire Phoenix.
No, the last three winners of the cup were the Riders, Eagles, and the Worcester Wolves in the COVID season. Got it.
Okay. 4 points. We'll take my
4 points. 4 points on the board there for you, and we move on.
We get a leaderboard. How far ahead?
Oh yes, let's give you some totals.
I would rather not see this leaderboard.
Nicholson still on 2 points. Come on, son. Got to get in there. 14 points for Grant, and Ads is streaking away in the lead with Rat Power with 19 points.
Ooh. We now hit
the black chair, the mastermind portion of the show. I'll do it in the order I've got it written down here. I don't really care if it's not the order we should do it in. But Grant, you're going first, and your selected category is the Glasgow Rocks between 2012 and 2017. What I shall do now
Emirates Arena era.
Is get the old stopwatch ready.
Oh, we didn't know there was time.
Ah, this is Mastermind. You got a minute and a half.
Oh, cool. Let's go. I can say pass.
So you can pass. You can obviously, although I never understood a pass, you might as well have just a wild stab in the dark. What's the worst that could happen? Indeed. So you have 1 minute 30. The buzzer will sound. I'll hold it up to the microphone. Technology as it is. And it will start when I ask the very first question. Are you ready? And we're off. Who led the Rocks in points per game in the 2016-17 season?
Neil Watson.
Correct. Who came the closest to recording a double-double with 14 points and 9.5 rebounds per game for the Rocks in the 14-15 season?
Kieran Achada.
Correct. Between 2012 and 2017, how many times did the Rocks miss the playoffs?
Once.
It is correct. What season was the Rocks' best league finish? Sorry, what position was the Rocks' best league finish? They did it twice.
Third.
Correct. How many finals did the Rocks make between 2012 and 2017?
Four.
Three is the correct answer. Which season did the Rocks move to the Emirates?
2012-2013.
Correct. How many fans were reported to have attended that first game at the Emirates?
5,500.
Just 5,000. What is the listed capacity of the Rocks Emirates Arena?
On what site?
Wikipedia.
6,500.
Correct. Who were the Rocks' opponents in for their first ever game at the Emirates?
Newcastle Eagles.
Correct. Which BBL final was played at the Emirates during this time? I've started, so I'll finish. Which BBL final was played at the Emirates during this time?
BBL Trophy.
Correct. Well played, sir. You've scored...
Wow.
You never hear him add it up on the telly, do you? You scored 8 in your specialist round. Congratulations. I should add, if you fly through it, there are only 12 questions, but...
What was my other questions? I'm annoyed now.
So you didn't pass on any, which is good. Your remaining questions were, how many times did Rocks players make the BBL Team of the Year from 2012 to 2017?
Five.
It was twice. Kieran Achara both times.
Oh, okay. I was saying All-British. Okay.
Well, that was the next question. Who were the only two players to make the All-Brit Team of the Year during that period?
Gareth and Kieran.
Yeah, it was Gareth and Kieran. Correct. Ads, my man. Unmute your mic, sir, because you are next in the firing line. Adam Masters, your specialist subject is Manchester Giants between 1989 and 2002. Are you ready?
Ready.
Your time starts now. How many Giants MVPs were there between that period of time?
None.
The answer is one. Who won the Giants' only MVP in 99-2000?
Tony Dorsey.
Correct. Which former MVP with the Leopards came to the Giants in the 98-99 season, gaining BBL Team of the Year selection?
John White.
Correct. Who was the first Giants player to receive BBL Team of the Year honours for the Giants in the 89-90 season?
Colin Irish.
Oh, no. It was Chris Kiernan. Kearney.
Oh, Chris Kiernan.
How many different Giants players made the Team of the Year during 89-2002 period?
15.
6. In the Giants, the Giants finished top of the Northern Conference, going on to win the playoffs in which season?
1999-2000.
Correct. In which season was the infamous Terrell Myers shot on the buzzer to pip the Giants to the league title?
Kiss me ass, Pabz. 98.
Which is the only competition silverware that has eluded the Giants?
The...
Time's up. Cup is correct. Adam Masters, you score a very respectable 5. The remaining questions were, in the 1998-99 season, which two Giants players led the league in scoring?
Dorsey and Heston?
John White.
John White.
Who played for the Giants from 1994 for 3 seasons before moving to the Sharks and Bullets before coming back in the year 2000?
Mark.
Mark Robinson, correct. Who won this? Who won his only career finals MVP whilst at the Giants in the 1999 trophy final?
Ronnie
Baker. Who was the only other player to record an MVP with the Giants? I don't know what I've done there. The answer somehow is Dorsey, because
yeah, Dorsey
doesn't make any. I've done that wrong, but we'll forget that one. We didn't come up, so that's handy. Oh, which leads us to Paul Nicholson.
Go on, Paul. I'm on 2 Paul points Nicholson, already.
The history of LVC Dusha.
Your specialist subject, Plymouth City Patriots 2021 to present. Yours is most recent in the memory. I hope you get a full house.
Yeah, but because of that, you've probably twisted these flipping questions.
I haven't.
What kind of socks did Kofi Joseph wear when he...
Don't say any more. Right, you ready? Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, your time starts now. Who was the first player to sign for the Patriots?
Denzel Ubiaro.
Correct. The Bristol Flyers were the Pats' first ever opponents, but what was the final score?
Oh, come on, man. Pats 74?
Wrong. 84-75 to the Flyers. Denzel Ubiaro led the scoring in that game with 25 points, but who had the highest index?
Rashad Hassan. Cam no, he King. Wasn't there. Crap.
Kofi Joseph recorded the club's highest single-game score with how many points?
46.
Correct. Who were the first two players to make the bench in the BBL All-Star 5?
Antonio Williams.
You've not listened to the question, have you?
Oh, no.
Denzel Ubiaro and Cam King. The Pats didn't record their first league win until January. Who were their opponents?
Team Wales. Oh, league win. Sorry, Scorchers. Sorry, my bad.
Who was the highest point scorer in the debut season for the club?
In the debut season for the club? Highest scorer... Antonio.
Rashad Hassan. Who were the first Patriots players to make the BBL All-Star 5?
Right, I'll go back to...
Do it quickly.
I'll go to Antonio and Deuce.
Antonio Williams and Rashad Hassan. Who were the first signings in the 2022-23... Who were the first signings in the 2022... Sorry. Who was the first signing for the 2022-23 season?
Oh, my days. Joe Hart.
Paul James. That's the one I did to trick you. That's the only one I did to trick you. The rest I thought you'd get. Jesus. As you can guess by the tone of my voice on your specialist subject, Paul Nicholson, you've scored 3.
Do you know what the annoying thing is? There's so many differences on some of the questions to answers from what we did and what happened publicly.
What?
Like signing times and things like that.
Well, we can only go by announced, I'm afraid.
Oh, mate. I'm trying to remember a scoreline. Who else had a scoreline?
Well, I would have thought you'd done some homework. It's your specialist subject, you know?
Like a season and 10 games.
I did no homework.
I thought you'd have that.
That happened before people were born.
Grant, what was Caledonia's first ever scoreline as Caledonia?
Well, he hasn't revised. That wasn't his specialist subject.
That wasn't my question.
That's what I'm saying.
Let's see if you can get any of your remaining questions. The highest point scorer was Rashad Hassan, because obviously he'd been there for a couple of months longer. And although I don't think he had higher points per game, he scored more points.
Yeah, yeah.
Who was the only player honoured in the end of year teams and awards?
The only player honoured?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
I was going to say Antonio, because there was the one that we moaned about a lot.
Roel Graham Bell was in the Brit team of the year.
Oh, British team of the year, wasn't he? Yeah. Sorry, I'm just thinking the team of the year.
This would be a good one. Paul James coached the team to a magnificent 8th finish from last place, but how many times was he coach of the month?
He got it in January, so I know that was one.
He didn't get it in January. He got it in February. That was it.
February, sorry, because of the wins in January. Didn't we start when the wins in January?
Yeah, end of January. 14th of January was the first win.
Yeah, got it Feb, sorry. Yeah, 2?
No, just Feb. The Pats made the 8th spot in their first ever season. But what was their win-loss record?
13-15.
Oh, you're so close. 12-15.
Okay.
Does anyone want to do Josh's questions? Because he's not here, just for a laugh.
I think it's a fail from me on that one.
What was his specialist subject?
So they've not gone to waste. His specialist subject was Tigers and Towers under his dad, basically, in the period of time when his Mick Bett was coaching.
I'm out.
I love that. Specialist subject.
Do you want to go? Shall I go through these or shall I not bother?
Yeah, I'll do it.
All right.
Picture of his dad in a uniform.
In the 1992-93 season, the Tigers made the playoff final, but who was their only player to feature in the team of the year?
92. Who are we here? Thames Valley?
Tigers, yeah. First six of Thames Valley questions.
Tony Holly?
No, Nigel Lloyd. Following season, the Tigers won the league, and Lloyd was joined in the team of the year by two more Tigers. Who were they?
What year?
Same year. The following year, sorry, 93-94.
Kevin St. Kitts.
Well, you were right with your father guess. It was Tony Holly and the other one was Pete Scantlebury.
Right.
Tony Holly was also made the trophy final MVP in 94, but who did the Tigers defeat to win the trophy?
The Worthing Bears.
The Manchester Giants.
Oh, shit, yeah, that's right, yeah.
How many times has the Tigers coach won the Coach of the Year honours? We know this from a question previously.
Twice,
and it was Mick Bett both times. Mick Bett won Coach of the Year twice, but how many times was he the South All-Star team coach?
Once.
It was once, and he won as well. And now it's the... Oh, no, one more Tigers question. Although the Tigers won the league in 94, who gave them a shock defeat in the playoffs in the first round, winning 2-0 in the first round series?
It'll be something like Chester or something.
It was Derby Bucks.
Derby Bucks.
Now the Towers questions are a bit more recent. Who led the Towers in points per game from 97 to the year 2000? Every season he won, he led them in points. He's on the cover of a couple of handbooks as well. Nicknamed Diamond.
Danny Lewis.
Yeah. Which BBL former player coach joined the Towers to win his eighth playoff title?
Which former players did what?
Which former player coach joined the Towers to win his eighth playoff title? Bearing in mind, he's the only player to win eight. It's a stock answer.
Alan Cunningham.
Yes. This is a good one. How many league MVPs have the Towers had in BBL history?
12.
None.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was just rubbing that one in.
Brilliant.
The Towers won the 97 BBL trophy. Who was the MVP of the game? And I didn't realise this either. I didn't remember this.
97.
Yeah.
Was it Buck?
No, it was Carl Brown. I forgot he even went there.
Ah.
The Towers also won the playoffs in that same season. Who was the MVP for that one? Keith Robinson.
Right.
In the 98-99 season, the Towers won the playoff finals. At what position were they in the league?
Third.
Correct. You don't get any points for that. Let's have a little summary after that. Nicholson on 5 points. Grant on 22 and Ad's in the lead with 24.
The positive is I'm the only person to more than double their score on that round.
Congratulations. Now, you have a real chance.
I've had questions from like last week.
So it's the final round, and believe it or not, you, Nicholson, sir, you still have a chance because what we're going into is guess the squad. You're going head-to-head, as in two at a time. I've picked a year and a squad of a team that you should or you may know some of, if not all, of the members of that squad. How it works is you have three lives. Every wrong guess, you lose a life. Every right guess, you gain a point. As you can imagine from a BBL squad, there's a fair number of points available on each guess. The first round is... Go on, Grant.
No, I was like almost like confused by the question. I'm like, this goes quite deep. I like this.
It's fairly.
You just picked a teammate and you name the players, isn't it?
Yeah. So
it's Grant versus Nicholson first. The year is not 2015-2016. The two squads, obviously, Glasgow Rocks for Grant. Plymouth Raiders for Nicholson.
I'm assuming 15 and 16. Oh my god, that's a long time ago.
So how it's going to work is you'll alternately pick. Now, these are the two squads up for grabs. If you think you know someone from the other team, you may still guess that player as well. In effect, taking that player away from the other player's points. So in effect, you've got a lot of points up for grabs here.
I'm just trying to figure out the bloody year.
2015-16, I told you that first.
You just said that. Come on, Paul.
Fine.
So let us begin. Grant, my man, you can go first.
Kieran Achara.
Correct.
Well, that's always like such a safe bet, isn't it?
Nicholson. You've a relatively safe bet in that squad as well. Maybe two.
Josh Wiltshire.
Correct.
Ooh.
I'll be honest.
Do I just keep going?
You'll go, yeah.
Warren Gillis.
Correct. Nicholson?
I think I know the season. Daryl Coletto.
Daryl Coletto is correct.
Well,
hang on. I need to start ringing these points up in the right column, otherwise Grant's going to walk away with an absolute landslide.
I'm okay with this.
Go on, what was your guess?
Will Hall.
Will Hall is correct.
Dante Williams.
Dante Williams is correct. Grant?
Rayleigh Grable.
Ooh.
Correct.
Grabo!
Nicholson?
Mike Vigo?
Correct. It's going well. This is going better than I thought it was going to go. Nick Grant, my man.
Johnny Bunyan.
Ah, yes. The Bunyanator himself. He was indeed there. Nicholson?
Try and remember how to pronounce his first name. His surname's McMillan. Oren McMillan.
Congrats. Yeah, well done. Good one.
Yeah, he came and went, but he was just a really cool dude, so I used to get on with him.
Grant?
He's a really cool dude. You just googled his name, did you?
I know, yeah. It was a weird name. Well, it's not really, to be fair. It's just...
He left halfway through the season. Am I allowed to say this?
If he's on this list, he can have it.
Marcus Ware?
Correct.
What a guess, by the way.
Oh, Nicholson.
Who else is there?
Is Nicholson scraping the
funny
barrel?
Thing is, this season, so that, like, there was a lot of comings and goings in that season.
There certainly was. In fact, you technically have more points on the board here than Grant does.
Dylan Costello.
Dylan Costello is correct. Grant, my man.
Who will I choose? Armin Mazic.
Correct.
Hey, Pabz is impressed we're going this deep.
Jeez. Oh, how did I forget Corey Dixon?
Yes, that was the year Corey Dixon was there. Well done.
I was going to steal him.
You could have done.
I could have, I should have. Bantu Butters, or Adam Butters, depending what you want to go by.
Is it Adam we've got there? We could give you that, Adam. Yeah.
Come on. How are we still going?
Good effort.
Yeah, but... Was this the year that he came in or not? Or did he come in the second year? What happens if I get one wrong? I got three lives, right?
You lose a life, yeah. We might reduce it. I didn't think it was going to go this well. I thought you'd need three lives. We may just say two lives.
Nah, stick to it, mate.
No, because we'll be here all night.
LVC?
No LVC, douche. You lose a life.
Okay.
Grant,
you don't lose any points there, right?
No, no, you don't lose any points.
Adam Hammerschmidt.
Correct. Nicholson.
Surname was Lewis. What was his first name? What was his first name? Ben Lewis, Benny, Ben, Ben.
Ben Lewis. Benny? Yeah, yeah, we'll go with that. Benny Lewis.
I can't remember what we called him now. He wasn't there for very long.
Grant, my man.
Jordan Clark.
Correct.
Ooh. I hope you have these on your list.
The fact you've said that he's got more names on his list is on than mine is really unfair.
No, because you can guess them as well.
I hope you got these ones on your list, because I will contest if you don't.
If I was you, I'd have gone Daryl Coletto straight away, taken that off the board, because he was there for like 5-6 years.
Jose Mayo.
Yes, Jose. Correct.
Yeah, Jose, sorry. Not Jose. Jose.
Tony Grant, my man.
Andre Stevens.
Correct. You've only got one left on that squad to pick.
No, I have.
Do you know who it is?
Yeah, because I know that. Can I let you know in a secret?
No.
That was the season I worked for the Rocks in the office. I don't want to leave. You could have picked a better season for me.
This is the season I used to go out on the drink with them all. Okay, if we had Jose, we've also got Jason Carr.
You have got Jason Carr, correct. Yeah. Go on then, who is it, Grant?
Jonathan Ndonga.
It is indeed. Full house for you.
Depends what you want to go by.
Yeah. Nicholson.
BJ Anthony.
Correct. Well, guys, you're full house on that one. Nicholson, you've got a few left, so you get an extra point each. Good. Well, you did very well. It's a draw. Congratulations.
Well done. Well played, Paul. That was the perfect season for me.
Yeah, well done. Nicholson, you're still in. Ads, we'll bring you into it. So Ads and Nicholson going head-to-head now. We will make it just two lives because that was very impressive. And I'm concerned that you guys are going to roll through this one as well. Nicholson, adds your year or your season is the 2017-18 season. Once again, Nicholson, it's the Plymouth Raiders for you. Adds, of course, Manchester Giants for you. Let's give Nicholson a breather and get Adds to go first.
2017-18. This is right. Once I've got one player, I'm away. It's just remembering which season it is.
There you go.
2017-18.
I got lucky in mine. Like, that was the perfect one for me.
David Kadiri.
Correct. Abs is off the mark. Nicholson?
I'm trying to work it out from who we had in the one you just asked me about with Grant. Who stayed, who went. Young guys, some of the young guys stayed, academy guys. Is Dylan Costello still there?
Dylan Costello is still there.
Okay.
Ads, my man.
Austin Rettig. The dunk champion.
Slam dunk champ, wasn't he? Yeah, well done. Yeah, he's there. Nicholson?
Actually, hold up a minute. If Costello's still there, that means Daryl's still there. Coletto's still there.
He's not for that season. You lose a life.
Ooh.
Ads, my man.
Isaac Banks.
Isaac Banks is correct.
Oh, crap. Okay. Put me on the back foot now. How many lives we got?
You got one left, but then Now, what do you want to do? Should we stick with three for this? Two.
Well,
yeah.
It's up to you.
You've lost one. You've got one left.
So if he's gone, that means we need a new point guard / shooting guard. Ooh. Grant will know him well. Neil Watson.
Correct.
So this must be the season after he left Glasgow then?
Massive fan of Neil Watson. I thought he was amazing.
Do you know he led the scoring for Leicester? The year he was in Leicester?
He was phenomenal. Everywhere he's been, he's been phenomenal. Incredible player. Dad's my man.
Callum Jones.
Callum Jones is correct. Back to you, Nicholson.
Hold up.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
James Jones. Steal.
He's out. I think he's out.
Oh, he's trying to steal.
I think he's done.
I'm just checking the list there.
Two or three.
Two?
Oh, shit. Sorry. No. Oh, I don't want to risk a steal yet. Shit.
Oh.
I thought he was three. Sorry. My bad.
Put your foot down, Pabz. Come on, chuck him out.
It was free for the first round.
I feel sorry for him. He's only got like 5 points. Go.
Nah, chuck him out. He's wrong.
Go on, Nicholson. I'll give you that.
I won't steal.
I wouldn't.
Okay. Now the I'll go with I know what our team is now, so I'll go with Jonas Javalainen.
Yeah. The hitman.
Hitman, indeed.
Ads.
Ingus Bankovic.
That's a bugger.
Ingus Bankovic is correct. Nicholson.
Louis Sayers
is correct. He was indeed there. Ads.
Clayfell Harris
is correct. You guys know your squads. Go on, Nicholson.
Yeah, you're picking them at really convenient times as well.
Well, I was trying to. Trying to make it entertaining. It's crap if you get them both wrong. I was going to do Kingston Kings versus Sunderland 76ers in the final of the playoffs. But
yeah, I think that would have failed, yeah.
Yeah, that would have crashed.
With Louis Sayers, you would also get Eddie Matthews.
Did indeed have Eddie Matthews. Well done.
Oh.
Yeah.
Is he then in Britain?
He played for a season, yeah, I believe.
Him and Louis are good mates.
That's my man.
I wouldn't have got that one.
Jordan Whelan.
Jordan Whelan is correct. Back to you, Nicholson. Skating on his last life.
So it is my last life.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we know that.
All right.
Because you almost gave it away.
I feel like he did give it away.
Yeah. We'll let him have it.
Behave yourselves. I had to put predictions in after the game's happened.
I wonder if that'll be mentioned once a show. It's consistent so far. Go on.
It will if he wins the predictions. ooh, Brandon Peel.
Oh.
No, he is. You are
Brandon Peel. Yeah.
And weirdly, he's listed as Brandon Penn.
No, huh. Oh, different people, are they not?
I'm assuming so.
Wait there. Did I say
Brandon Peel never played for Plymouth?
Not Brandon Peel.
It's weirdly, he's listed as Brandon Penn. That's a struck life. It is sudden death. So, Ads, you get this one, you knock him out completely.
It is Brandon Penn as well.
Ads, you knock him out completely.
Oh, my God.
Jarrell Okoro.
And there he is. Yes, Jarrell Okoro is correct. You get a bonus point for winning the round, which sets up the final doubleheader, the round robin. So, time for Ads and Grant to go head to head. It's the 2013-14 season. So we've got Rocks 2013-14. And we've got the Giants 2013-14.
I'm going to have to play it. Okay. Hustling. I'm hustling this one.
We're ready then.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, we'll let Grant go first because he's had a breather. Go on then, Grant.
Sterling Davis.
Sterling Davis, BBL legend, is correct. Ads, my man.
Yorick Williams.
Yorick Williams, straight out of the bag, is correct.
Okay. See, I'm going to know a couple in whether I'm right or wrong about the season. I'm thinking.
Yeah, Yorick could be any.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah.
You've got to go Gareth Murray then.
Gareth Murray is correct. Well done.
Stefan Gill.
Stefan Gill is correct. Can I just tell you as well that the points, as it stands at the moment, there's 2 points in it in favour of Grant right now. So it could be all on this one. Grant, your turn.
Point guard, I think, was EJ Harrison.
EJ Harrison is correct.
Okay, so it's that season.
Add.
Callum Jones.
Callum Jones is correct. It's getting tense, isn't it?
Johnny Bunyan.
Oh, is Johnny Bunyan is correct.
He's been around a long time. He might be the big, the what do you call it, LVC?
Yeah, the youngest veteran.
Well, Johnny's 30 and played more seasons.
Yeah, very true.
James Jones.
James Jones is correct. Over to you, Grant.
This can make or break this team selection on this one, because if this is the season I think it is, and the only reason I think I'm getting close is because it's the season I don't think we made the playoffs, which is one of my special questions you asked me. So
special question.
Well, whatever my specialised round, every question for me is special. I'm going to, and if I get this one, I'm going to get a few of this squad. So Daniel Norden.
Correct.
Oh, Ads, be afraid. Be afraid.
On you, Ads, my man.
Worst rocks squad.
Mike Bernard
is correct.
Chez Marks
was indeed there. That's one man.
David Alliou.
David no. Alliou is correct.
Legend. Okay. So if it is the Northern season, so Marco Tulio. Oh, he definitely played in Northern.
Alex Marco Tulio.
Aye. Marco Tulio.
So I'm looking at Marco Tulio, so I'm looking under T. But you're correct. He was there. That's okay. My man. You panicked a bit then, didn't you?
I was like, I definitely knew that when he played in Northern.
Tintin.
Oh, player.
Who?
Tintin Watts.
David Watts.
Oh, yeah. David Watts. Was that his nickname?
Hmm.
I never knew that.
Oh, he was a player. What's his first name? Don't want to have a Brandon Peel incident here.
Brandon Penn.
Johnson's his surname. Was it CJ? CJ? Chris Johnson?
Chris Johnson is correct.
Oh, he's on this.
That's my man.
Rob Marsden
is correct.
Good BBL player.
Yeah, solid.
Oh, Fran Early.
Correct.
Why the doubt? Don't do this to me. The pause is a killer.
Tense, isn't it? Tense.
Play some music.
Well, as a man.
Well, think about what I'm going through, because I thought we only had about four players that season.
Every one of them an absolute BBL vet and absolute baller.
Yeah, but we're going to be getting... Right. There's two names that are springing to mind, and one of them's risky. In fact, they're both risky. Did Percy play for them that year? Anthony Purcell?
He certainly did.
Nah.
Well done, sir.
Hey, this is the last one I'm sure of, and is Patrick Manifold.
Patrick Correct. Manifold. That sounds like a...
Stop.
That sounds like the
we'll get cancelled.
The human name of a Transformer or something. What's your name? Patrick Manifold.
Oh, good Lord.
Oh, man, I'm in trouble here.
Well, you've both got two lives.
Did Nathan play that year? Nathan Schall played one of them seasons. Nathan Schall.
He didn't play that season. He lost one life. Grant.
Oh. Fraser Glass. Oh, did he? Yeah. There's another young Scottish guy.
Well, no, he didn't. No, you're not there. You've lost a life as well. Ads, my man.
I've said James, haven't I? James Jones.
Yes.
Does the coach count?
Only if he played.
That doesn't. Mine was a player coach. That's not fair.
Well, Jeff Jones. oh, man. I started with your. Jesus. He would have been around then. It was right Robbie days.
Did you just have a. Was that just a year of British guys?
Yeah, it was.
Was that one of the first seasons?
It's the big forgotten thing about they actually did make the playoffs back then with an all British team.
With an all Brit team,
a really strong, and mainly Mancunians as well. Jeez. Oh, did my dear friend Dre play that his season that year? Gale.
He certainly Andre did. Gale. He did, yes.
Dre played Correct. That year.
He did.
Yes, Dre.
Right.
Legend.
I've only got one guess left because if you said no to Fraser Glass, I'm going to say Dale Greave.
Correct. Dale Greave was there. Ads.
I think I'm done.
Oh, God. How many more names are on the list, Pabz? Because there can't be many.
You've actually got six names left.
Really? What? Jesus. Six names.
What have I got? Fans?
One.
Mascots? Owners?
One name. It's tough to do. I'll be honest, I assumed you'd all be out a lot earlier. And it wouldn't matter.
Is it my turn?
I'm deeply impressed. It's your go.
The loser is yawning. The loser is yawning.
I'm wondering whether Barry Webster played that year. Do I go with Barry Webster? What was that other guy called?
Have you lost a life? I shouldn't be asking this because I can't remember.
Yeah, I lost a life.
You're both on your last life.
It could be for
the win then.
Jimmy Page. Not Jimmy Page. He's the fucking guitarist in Led Zeppelin. Keith Page.
Correct.
No. You're meant to get that wrong, mate.
Last life.
Hold up. Did you say Jimmy Page and then get an answer change?
No, he was saying to himself.
Pen and Peel. You know, just
well, that's nothing like
Or like James Jones before you guessed that and would have lost your life. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, oh sorry, my microphone's gone on mute again.
Come on then, Grant.
I don't know. I must have said about 10 guys. We cut.
You said a lot.
We cut Chez Marks and brought in Marco Tullio. Chris Johnston that came in, but who did he come in for? Because we had an import slot because Marco Tullio's British. So it was an import of such. I have zero. Well, there's a guy, if it's the Fran early season, there's a guy that never played an official game for the Rocks who was signed. Martin Zelenic, but he or Zelikic, but he never played an official game, so I'm not giving that as an answer. Because we had two Croatians at pre-season. I have no idea. Owen McAnally, I know that's not right. He's a different season.
No, it was Antonio Di Maria. So, adds to steal the round.
I feel like I've blown my load completely here.
Well, if you can guess, I'll give you an idea of the magnitude. If you guess this right, hang on, let me just check. Count up. Yeah, you're both on 11. If you can get this right, that point and the bonus point will mean you guys will be tied.
Off Google. Give up, Pabz. Give up now. I want to go to bed.
Barry Webster is all I've got.
It's not Barry Webster. So you both tie. Your remaining guesses, if it's worth anything, were Ika Amutsa. I can't even say the last name. Amutsa Stiga? Stegi? Something like that. Chris. Right. Buana, Paul Cantwell.
Shit, Paul Cantwell. Paul Cantwell's the guy who's second assistant on the bench now.
Ape Amadou Sam, S-A-M-B, and Connor Tuxford.
Wow.
So there we are, which brings the quiz to a close, a dramatic finish to what has been an epic quiz. Thank you very much for joining me. The final scores as they stand: Paul Nicholson finishes with 22 points.
Solid effort.
Adam Masters finishes with 45 points. And your winner, and I will just scroll up very quickly, make sure I've not given him any points he's not worthy of. No.
Ah, well done, me.
No, it's all his. The winner with 47 points. Grant Young.
Come on! Well done, Bingo. Hey, we not noticed since the pep talk, since Bingo and I had a chat, started doing well.
Unbelievable.
So, who knew?
There you are.
4-year-old Bingo would be the one to save me.
Well done, everyone. And happy Christmas to everyone. I hope you had a great day. Obviously, it's Boxing Day today, so I hope you had a great day. I will no doubt have put on a stone and... we'll be laying slumped in a corner somewhere full of pigs in blankets. We've got 60 pigs in blankets to get through. Been stockpiling them for a while now. So,
how many is the rest of the family eating?
No, they're mine. No, none. They're not having any of mine. And what? You know? Come on. So, yeah, any festive messages for anyone out there? Ads first.
Festive messages? Is it all over yet?
Father Ted speech coming.
Do they still play Morecambe and Wise this time? Yeah, they normally put Morecambe and Wise on the telly. They always used to enjoy that.
Cancelled.
Wow. Yeah, probably have. You're probably right. Nicholson, sir, anything to say before we go?
Sorry, that last round took so long. I didn't even realise I was still in this podcast right now.
You've not been in it since the first round, mate.
No, I hope everyone had a wonderful Christmas. And back to it on the 28th.
Yeah.
Flyers. Southwest Derby, baby. Woo-woo.
Full of cheese. Game on.
What?
I'll see you on the 28th. Sorry, I'll be full of cheese.
Fair enough. Cheese and pegs.
Yeah. Oh,
Pabz. Turkey,
bacon, stuffing. I told you, I'll put on a stone. Then the winner of the competition, Grant, my man, anything to say in closing?
Oh, just would like to thank Ads for the competition, Paul for turning up.
You're welcome.
Pabz, no, thanks, man. Pabz, thanks for everything.
Pabz for putting a lot of time and effort into doing this.
Cheers, Pabz.
My pleasure, gentlemen. My pleasure.
You're the man, Pabz.
I would like to also thank Bingo, because I don't think without Bingo, I would have possibly won my reindeer jumper. And yeah, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Game on. Well, thank you to you guys for putting up with me for this, for the year. Me texting you, messaging everyone, saying everyone game for Tuesday night, Monday night. Can anyone do 8 o'clock? Can anyone do half eight? And then in the end, we go on at 10 o'clock anyway. So thanks for that. It's fun though. Hopefully you enjoy it. And we'll have more next year, 2023. Bring it on, and maybe, just maybe, pick up some sponsors and get some money.
Ooh,
yes. New Year's resolutions.
Who knows? Stranger things could happen. Right.
If you wish to sponsor the Below the Rim podcast.
Yeah, we do live readings. Have you ever needed a hat? No? Okay. This look there was absolutely
My name
perfect.
Is Paul, and I couldn't do without this cream. Oh, sorry, what?
Fellas, thank
like
you.
BrewDog.
Yeah, BrewDog would be a big one. Get creative. Mind you, they wouldn't sponsor you, Nicholson, for BrewDog, because you're probably one of their biggest purchasers. They'd take too much of a hit if you if they suddenly start giving you crates. Right, thanks, fellas. Thanks for listening, everybody. Happy Christmas, and we'll see you all. Well, I was going to say in the new year, but some of you, if you watch on the 28th, we'll be sticking around there. And Ad, you got any games, Mystics games or anything coming up?
No, it's all quiz goes a bit quiet now. Giants. Got a game this week, I think. But yeah, it's pretty quiet on the Mystics and Magic side of things.
Well, look out for my man there, Ads, on the comms.
Mm-hmm.
That's sterling work. Anyway, thank you very much for listening. As I said earlier, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Ho, ho, ho.
Green Giant.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. Blazing, you'll be for us. Strike the harp and join the chorus. Follow me in merry measure while I tell of Yuletide treasure. Fa la 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 la